Good morning, traders. It's the 5th of June 2013. Welcome to this Platinum update. We have made some enhancements to the system which we think you would be interested in having a look at. So I have got a euro dollar chart here which I'm just going to load up. I'm going to add the Platinum Expert Advisor onto the chart, do a bit of shifting and making it visible for us. So let's draw a trend line first of all, just roughly, and I'm going to put some resistance levels up there. I'm also going to go to my cable chart and do something similar so I can demonstrate this new functionality for you. So it's a nice trend line, gain through resistance, and I load the Platinum Expert Advisor on this chart too. So when I click on the Platinum icon, the usual interface with some enhancements comes up. So first of all, I'm going to scan my chart and it's giving me details of the trend lines that I've just placed on the chart. The first thing to mention is we've added a symbol filter. So we don't want to see all the other trend lines, we just want to look at the trend lines we've drawn on the cable chart. Just select the GBP/USD symbol filter. And now you can only see the sterling US dollar trend lines in the selected trend line drop down combo box. So let's say, for example, I'm interested in configuring this trend line 628 down here. So I select trend line 628. It tells me it's not currently configured for auto trading. Let's now configure it. So let's make it a buy, a touch based trade when price action touches the trend line within 2 pips, plus or minus 2 pips. We'll trade 0.4 lots and we'll set a stop loss of 20 pips and we'll then exit when we'll take half the trade out at 50 pips and we'll take the remainder of the trade out at 40 pips. So I can save those settings, right click on the chart and just show object descriptions. I also want to show my grid, set the maximum orders to trend line to 60 minutes. Maximum risk to 2%, show order joins, and I just want to go to my display controls, show my TP and SL grid data. I want my SL grid data to be, say, red, and my TP grid data to be green. And now when I save those settings, you can now see we have our levels being set. We notice the TP2 level doesn't look quite correct, so let's just go back into our profit controls and we just didn't edit that correctly, so make sure 40 is selected, save those settings, and now we've got a correct TP1 and TP2 exit, one at 20 pips, one at 40 pips. Now let's say we like this strategy and we think we're going to deploy this on multiple charts. So what we can do with the new profiles option is select new profile, and then we can call this profile whatever we like, so buy 2 TP, and call it 50-50, as it's 50% scale out, and we can just say SL equals 20. So this reminds us of what this profile is. So when we save that profile, we can now use that and deploy that on any other chart we want. So let's say, for example, I go to Eurodollar chart here, and I turn my symbol filter onto Eurodollars, and we can see the two trend lines. Let's just mouse over these trend lines, see what they are. So our support trend line is 608. Go to 608, tells me it's not configured. Now simply reselect that profile we just made up. Click save, go to properties on the chart, show object descriptions. Wait for a couple of ticks. And you can now see that profile has been applied. So very, very easy to reuse your profiles that you've defined. And that's really powerful. You can hold up to 50 profiles in here, which is a pretty manageable amount. You can also edit profiles, update profiles. So for example, let's say we want to adjust this profile, maybe change the display controls and the trend line color to say white and use a solid white color for the trend line. When I save those settings, now you can see the display has been changed and I can now update the profile. So then when I go back to my sterling chart, reapply that trend line to the trend line number 628. You can now see we very easily changed that accordingly. The other thing we've done is we've added an option whereby if you're using a filter on a certain oscillator and that's selected, whatever value you want in there, etc., the filter controls button is now highlighted in orange to remind you there's an active filter running. So clearly if we go back and turn the filter off, the button will go back to its normal color. So those are the key changes we've made recently. Once again, symbol filter, the profiles option with up to 50 trader definable profiles, and also the ability to update them, to delete them, and to obviously create new ones. So those are the updates we've made, and if anyone has any questions, please don't hesitate to get in touch.